Alright guys, we're going to have a bit of a lazy day today because I've been video editing the gaming project for like the past 5 hours and my brain is fried. And if I have to deal with Nicki Minaj or some other thing that's going on, I'm probably going to explode. So let's just have an easy day. Let's do a reaction. Tom McDonald has dropped this with Drax. Let's see. It's called Propaganda. So I'm interested. I know Drax has done stuff with Tom McDonald in the past. Let's hit it and let's break it all down and we'll talk about the politics aspect of it.
Hey, Daryl. Good, bro. Ain't picking up calls, dog. What's wrong, man? Daryl, you good?
Whites and lefts and rights to stop the madness. They planned it. It's Trump or Biden. We all been divided by it in the streets. Elections always been rigged. I ain't surprised when somebody cheats. All I see is pentagrams and the propaganda, but our priority's the vaccine. It ain't hard for wolves to find a flock when the sheep are fast asleep. Too many people like character. Too many journalists scaring you. Too many pencils attempting to rewrite the Constitution. They probably gonna tear it up. I love the country, but I don't trust the people taking care of us. We went to bed with the American dream. We woke up in Nightmarica.
And all I see is propaganda. All I see is propaganda. Propaganda. And all I see is propaganda.
I like this song. We'll break it down in a sec, guys. We're just watching it for a reaction. Right, okay. Alright, so interesting. Very interesting. First thing is more interesting is the fact that it's only got 189,000 views. Yeah. Although it is on Dax's channel, so... yeah. Maybe it would have done better on Tom's channel. Did he put it on his own channel? So it's on Dax's.
Tom McDonald. No. Okay, so it's only on Dax. So it must be a Dax was featuring Tom, right? Which makes sense. That's what it says in the title. All right, so let's breaking it down. First things first. Like, holy dooly, this song is... Yeah, no. It's a good song. I like it. It's... The beat's okay, but we're not here for the beat or anything like that. You got rappers who break down the beats and stuff. Let's break down the message, right? Let's do it verse by verse. And we'll break it all down. Now, the interesting thing here is he turns up to his mate's house, and his mate is literally just sitting there in front of the TV with, like, them just, like, feeding him info. I presume this is some sort of information stream or something like that. Tell me that's not accurate. And then, of course, you've got, you know, the TV flashing things like dismiss the people's news, right? And you got, obviously, you know, you got the news, you know, feeding him information. And it's coming out of their mouth straight into his chest, right? It's going straight into him. So, yeah, definitely get that. I also was looking there and I saw like media's something, and then it says like fear on something, like, yeah, it's like it's all sensationalized headlines that's been flashed on the screen that's feeding this guy. Now it's interesting here is that everybody's glued to their mobile phones. And this is something that even the Matrix has pointed out. Like, guys, people on the left and right are calling this, and people are still glued to their phones and they're not listening. Put your phones down. There is a big world out there, and you shouldn't have to see it through your mobile phone. It's like he's trying to get people's attention and no one's taking any notice because everybody is just glued to that device. Like, where I am right now, my mobile phone has not been near me for hours. I used to be really bad at the mobile phone. Mobile phone would buzz, message, email, anything. I would go and check it. I learned years ago that was a bad thing. It was actually my ex that actually went through and sort of woke me up to that a bit, because she used to say all the time, well, you always run to your phone. Why are you always running to your phone? She was right. I always did. So I ended up stopping her. United we stand, divided we fall. It's been New Year's Eve since they've dropped the ball. This is what Tom keeps singing about, right, at the end of the day, is that they keep putting us in boxes, dividing us, getting people to go through and put themselves in different boxes and in different groups so that you can get the groups and the boxes fighting each other. We have to stop that. We have to stop that and realize that our common enemy is the people in the tower, the elites, the ones that are sitting there, the warmongers, the military industrial complex, the media industrial complex, the ivory tower, silver spoon. They're the ones that we should be fighting, not ourselves. Because while we're fighting ourselves, they're bringing in rules and legislation and bending the rules of the law of the country to what they want. And while we're all distracted with the fighting amongst ourselves, they're getting away with literally murder. And how we dead in the game, we don't write to the sound of applause. And the truth that it lines ain't never signed, stood and remain the boss. In a world that is full of facades, where if you speak, you get nailed to a cross. I won't be silent, I am outspoken, I am the product of pain. It's interesting that the news comes on TV, everybody looks at it. It's because everybody's so desperate for that information fix. You know, they're so brainwashed that as soon as the news comes on, everybody looks at it. So when you see my name, no fame could never break down a brain that is already broken. And it literally says there on the TV, news you can trust. I wonder if that's a subtle dig at some company that has a C and an N in their title. Brain that is already broken. Every wound is a pain devotion. They fill words as I purge emotions. Scabs hair as I drop hits that bleed loud from demonic omens. The system decides we spend. And then obviously they've watched the news. The news has obviously presumably said something about Dax. And they've all just started pointing their cameras at him to record him. Because they probably said, you know, he's, you know, something. Right? Insert blank here. So at the end of the day, they've all pointed their cameras and faced it at him. We bow while most of our time is spent in bed. The dreams we have all stay inside. We sleep and wake and live with regret. The price of life is half the cost. The price of fame could cost your head. If infamy is what you seek in propaganda, and all I see is propaganda. Everybody in this clip is tuned into their phone like a zombie. The guy driving is still looking at his mobile phone. The people walking, they're not even watching where they're going. They're just banging into people because they're so tuned into their mobile phone. Oops, too far. He's right. We need balance. We need left and right. We don't just need the right. We just don't need the left. In balance. The problem is that the left is so far off the reservation right now. But regardless. And this is what we're seeing in America right now. Is we're seeing this balance. We're seeing the pendulum shift. Right? It goes far left. Then it comes swinging back to the conservatives. Then it goes back to the left. And then it goes back to conservatives. It's this balance that he keeps speaking of. At the moment, we don't have much balance. The government is controlled. Three government branches is all controlled by the Democrats. The only power the right has is Twitter and maybe Fox News, but they're still establishment. It's Trump or Biden, we all been divided by it in the streets. Elections have always been rigged. I ain't surprised when somebody cheats. All I see is pentagrams and the propaganda, but our priority is the vaccine. It ain't hard for wolves to find a flock when the sheep are fast asleep. Oof, I love that line. It's not hard for the wolves to find the sheep when they're fast asleep. I love that line. I really, really do. Fast asleep because everybody's looking at their phone. Nobody's watching. Nobody's watching what the elites are doing. Well, you know, a few of us are, but how many people in the real world? And obviously, look, at the end of the day, people that come to my channel, Tim Pool's channel, or whatever it may be, it's some alternative, right? Obviously, we all have a innate curiosity to find out what's really happening in the world, right? But to be honest, we're a small fraction. We're 1 out of 10 people. You know, that's what I was watching a song the other day. They turned around and they said, you know, we don't need to rig elections when we've got 10 people for every one that's awake. You know, while there's one of us that's awake, there's 9 or 10 others that are asleep. You look at, go to work and look around. Just look at the people that are just sitting there as zombies on their phones or just sitting there watching the news, just absorbing it all and believing what they're being told. How many times has the news been caught lying this week alone? We'll go in the past 2 weeks. Jen Psaki yesterday got up and responded to a question from, I think it was Fox News, where he asked about why the red states were getting their IV of antibiotics or antibodies or whatever it was, why they're getting cut. And she says, oh no, that's not true. And then proceeds to literally verify what he asked after she said it wasn't true. No, I actually, let's show you the clip. But I commented on it and people have been blowing up my Twitter. Just like retweeting it. It's got so many retweets. So it's had 300 likes at the moment. For me, that's pretty damn impressive. So this is it here. So, did she just confirm that they were cutting supplies to the red states after saying that the reporter's questions about them cutting supplies to the red state was inaccurate? Now, let's just... Sorry, guys. Ear dropped.
President's COVID plan.
He promised about right.
The president's COVID lives and data...
Let's just listen to what she says.
...available showed a waning efficacy of vaccines after a certain number of months. ...waning efficacy of vaccines. I do have another question about the president's COVID plan. He promised on September 9th that he was going to send 50% more supply of monoclonal antibodies to states. Yet... the Biden administration is cutting supplies in red states by 50%. So, for example, you know, in Florida, they were expecting to get 70,000 doses this week, which they say they need. They're only getting 30,000 doses. And this is not just for unvaccinated people. In South Florida, half the people who are seeking this treatment are fully vaccinated. So why is the Biden administration cutting these supplies?
Now, that was her question, right? Why is the Biden... administration cutting these supplies?
That's not accurate.
That's not accurate, right? That's what she said. That's not accurate. That question that you just asked is not accurate. Now, watch her response.
So let me give you the accurate information. First of all,
right, now remember, it's not accurate. They're not cutting supplies.
Now we're shipping an average of 150,000 doses per week. Over the last month, though, and one thing that I think people need to understand for clarity, facts, I know you're like facts, is that monoclonal antibodies are life-saving therapies that are used after infection to prevent more severe outcomes. So clearly the way to protect people and save more lives is to get them vaccinated. So that
the reporter had just asked you about these antibodies and said that people in South Florida are actually needing them after they've been vaxxed. So your statement there about getting more people vaxxed, how many more vaccinations do the people in South Florida need to get when they're fully vaccinated? But yet they're still wanting the antibodies. So that's more bullshit, but anyway.
They don't get the COVID to begin with. But over the last month...
Getting the vax does not stop you from getting COVID. It just makes the symptoms less.
Given the rise in cases due to the Delta variant and the lower number of vaccination rates in some of these states, like Florida, like Texas, just seven states are making up 70% of the orders. Our supply is not unlimited, and we believe it should be equitable across...
We believe it should be equitable. Why are you cutting the supply to red states? We're not. We're cutting supplies to the red states because we want it to be equitable. I think my brain just exploded.
States across the country. Do you...
So, you know, like I say, literally lying. They're full of it. They are literally liars. And of course, no one in the mainstream media called her out for this.
Too many people...
Some jerk off on Twitter, me, I did. But no one else did.
A character. Too many journalists scaring you. Too many pencils attempting to rewrite the Constitution. You probably gonna tear.
Too many journalists scaring you. Too many pencils trying to rewrite the Constitution. We hear about them taking away gun rights and stuff like that. The media is constant fear, 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 fear. Die of COVID. You're gonna die of COVID. You gotta get the vax. Gonna die. Gonna die. Fear sells. If it bleeds, it leads, right?
I love the country, but I don't trust the people taking care of us. We went to bed with the American dream. We woke up in Nightmarica. And all I see is propaganda. Propaganda. And all I see is propaganda.
Really good song. As for the meaning, I love the meaning. The song itself is not bad. I like it. It's not one of my best. It's not one of the ones I like the most. At the moment, that's actually Dead Man Walking, but regardless. Not one of either of those two, but someone else. But at the end of the day, but that's because I've had to listen to it 400 times. Video editing. But as for this, yeah, like I say, at the end of the day, I love the meaning. I like the song. It's a good song. And it has a really good meaning behind it. Guys, I will put a link in the description below to Dax. If you haven't subbed to him, please feel free to go and do that. Also, I will put also a link to Tom McDonald as well. So obviously feel free to go and check him out and give him a sub as well. But yeah, guys, at the end of the day, really good song. I love it. And I might actually have to listen to more of Dax's. I've been slipping on Dax a little bit, so I might have to listen to more of his stuff. I know he's done stuff with Tom before, so I don't know. Maybe I like his stuff. Maybe we should check it out. Let us know what your thoughts are in the comment section below regarding the song. Did you like it? Did you think, maybe not? Let us know what your thoughts are in that comment section below. Obviously, this video has been helpful. Please smack that like button. If you're new to the channel, welcome and subscribe. Apart from that, guys, we'll see you in the next Demonetized video from YouTube. Have a great night and enjoy.